This is Paritosh Painter here, and today I'm going to talk to you guys about my life in theatre, how it all started from my college days to where I am right now, what I'm doing, how theatre has helped me grow in my life, in my career. So to start with, my career actually took off from my college. When I started participating in intercollegiate drama competitions, I represented Mithibai College, and fortunately for me, the cultural wing was very strong during our times, and we had a lot of students who were that time just a regular student along with me, who have now gone on to become celebrities right now, from choreographers to music directors to hairstylist to PR agencies to actors to various fields in entertainment. And like I said, my career started from Mithibai College when I started participating in the intercollegiate drama competitions. And we used to really have a great time participating in those competitions. And we had a professor who used to teach us drama. His name was Anshumali Ruparel, and so we were all his students. He taught us how to come on stage, walk on stage, face the audience, take the lights, not cross our lines, how to emote dialogues. So he taught us basically everything. We were novice in theater because I had never done theater before. I had participated in probably some mono acting competitions during my school days, but that was it. So for me, in college, theater was a new beginning. And so like I was saying, luckily we had a great batch. To name a few from our batch who are excelling in their fields right now. So we had Vivek Oberoi, we had Shreyas Talpade, we have choreographers Bosco Caesar, who were a part of our batch, Ashwini Kalsekar, Ninad Kamath, who's a great voiceover artist right now. We had Hakim Alim, who is a celebrity hairstylist right now, Parag Desai, who heads one of the biggest PR firms in the Bollywood industry. So it was a great beginning. We all got together, and then in the year 1996, when I had just passed out of my college, I started my own theater company, that is Ideas the Entertainment Company. And I was fortunate enough to partner with my godfather, who I may call Mr. Dinyar Contractor, and we started this company together, Ideas the Entertainment Company. And I did my first play along with Dinyarji, and that play was called Whose Wife Is It Anyway. We went on to do about 400-500 shows of that play, and it was a great experience. So the way Anshumali Ruparel, our college professor, taught me how to be on stage, what to do, how do I emote on stage, Dinyarji taught me one important thing, which I still follow it strictly. And he told me one thing, Paritosh, that when people come to watch theater and people come to see any sort of entertainment, when they buy ticket worth 100 rupees, they expect entertainment worth 200 rupees. So when you are doing a comedy play or something that is going to entertain the audience, you have to make sure that you entertain them and entertain them beyond their expectations, and that's where you will go on to be successful. So from that play onwards, from Whose Wife Is It Anyway, which went on to became a full-length feature film later on, which was directed by Rohit Shetty, and the title of the film was All the Best. So that was my first play. So that's where I started my journey with Mr. Dinyar Contractor, and then from there on we went on to produce and make beautiful plays, entertaining plays, hilarious plays, laugh riot plays. Dinyarji himself was an amazing personality, learned a lot from him. I think my second play, which was Liar Liar, so that's that was my second play. Then we went on to produce another play called Madhouse. Then we did a play called I Do I Don't, which was a musical. That was the first musical for me, so we had incorporated a lot of parodies and it was a fun thing. So it not only the first musical for me, but it was the first play where we I experienced for the first time revolving sets, because till my first three productions there was just box sets, and this was my first experience with the revolving set, and it was great fun. Music, dance and comedy mixed, where Dinyarji used to play 9 different characters, and so it was fun. Then after I Do I Don't, there was this play called I Love You Too, which was the first play which was officially written by me, because till that time we used to do a lot of adaptations, etc. But that was officially written by me. That was called I Love You Too. Post I Love You Too, we did another play called Amar Akbar and Tony, which was produced along with Dinyarji and myself by Sangeeta Bijlani. So that was my play. And then so that was Amar Akbar and Tony. And I think post Amar Akbar and Tony, Dinyarji decided to venture more into Gujarati theatre, and I was not so keen on Gujarati theatre. I was very comfortable with doing English and Hindi theatre. And also during that time I started my own television production company as well, Ideas, and I produced my first show, Home Sweet Home, for ZTV. So that's when theatre took a little backseat for me, actually. So theatre took a little backseat for me, and I concentrated more on television productions. I produced a couple of shows, and then I got back to theatre when with a play called Uncle Samjha Karo, which was the Hindi adaptation of my play. So I got back to Hindi theatre. Till that time, mostly we concentrated on I was concentrating on English theatre, because Dinyarji was involved with me. Post that, I launched my first Hindi play, Uncle Samjha Karo, which again, actually that was the play which Rohit saw, and Rohit adapted it into the film, All the Best. Post Uncle Samjha Karo, I did Ye Dil Mange Mor, Ye Kya Ho Raha Hai. Ye Kya Ho Raha Hai was a great experience, because that was the first time ever we tried something on the lines of Broadway, where we had supposed. So Ye Kya Ho Raha Hai was an experiment in itself, where we had booked an entire auditorium for a period of 2 months, and we had shows every day, like the way they do it Broadway or West End. And it was a great experience where we used to come every day, perform. You know, we had sometimes, you know, weekdays, Friday, Saturday, Sundays, we used to have good audience, about 80% capacity. Wednesday, Thursdays was decent, 50% capacity, but it was Mondays and Tuesdays were the worst, where we used to have hardly about 20-30 people sitting in the audience, but in an auditorium of capacity of 800. But it was great fun even performing for those 20 people, because the kind of response we used to get for that particular play, it was great fun. It was a great experience. It was the first time ever that a play was done continuously for 60 days without a break. So it was an experiment itself. We were pretty successful, though we haven't attempted it again, but it was great fun. And when I actually did that show for 60 days, I thought of a concept called the Mumbai Theatre Festival. So I hosted the first Mumbai Theatre Festival where we had 20 plays from of different languages, four of Hindi, four of Gujarati, four of Marathi, four English. So we had these plays continuously playing at Rangsharda, which also was very popular, the whole theatre festival. So theatre has been a great experience for me. Theatre is very gratifying, and the best part about theatre is you get your gratification there and then. If you're good, you're good. You hear the audience's clap. If you're bad, you hear those sighs from the audience where you've not cracked a great joke and you're trying hard. So yes, so that was my journey in theatre. I love theatre. Theatre for me is kind of a stress buster. When I'm on stage, I really forget about everything what's happening in the whole world, and it's just me and my co-actors and the audiences, and the only thing on my mind is how to make them laugh and how to entertain them. So it's good fun. Our latest play, Three Cheers, unfortunately we only got to do one show before the whole lockdown process, and we are just hoping that we are able to do more shows once the lockdown opens up. So yes, Anuprita, hopefully we'll be able to do more shows, and let's see how it all goes. So that's my journey about theatre. Another play of mine called Paying Guest, which was adapted in a Hindi film. The rights were bought by Mukta Arts Subhash Ghai, and it was made into a Hindi film, Paying Guest. So fortunately, I've been fortunate enough that a couple of plays of mine have been picked up by eminent producers and directors, and are being made into motion pictures. The best part about doing plays, of adapting plays into a television or what do you say, a film format or a web series, is you know that there are certain things that have worked, and it makes it's a good bet. One of my plays, Double Trouble, has been adapted into a web series, which is an old Balaji called Baby Kamna. So it's been a great journey. So theatre has been very gratifying. It's been fun. It gives me a direct connect with my audiences. So that's the best part about it. If I have to, because I do a lot of writing for television and films, if there are certain sequences, there are certain punches which I don't know whether they will work or not, but when I crack them in front of my audiences, if they laugh, then the punch works for me. If they don't, I know that this is not working and I need to improve on it. And then I work on how to make it better, and then apply that on television and film. So theatre gives me that direct connect with my audiences on what works, what doesn't work. So it's been a fun journey, and I'm loving it, and I hope to do more plays and come up with more shows and different kind of shows, not limiting myself to just doing plays, but also doing some other kind of live events. And yes, talking about Women Decoded, Manish, it was an experience for me because I never I'm very comfortable with a set of actors around me. So for me, doing Women Decoded was challenging because to be all alone on stage and to continuously engage your audience for 2 hours is difficult. And not only just go speak, but also to entertain them and also to keep them laughing was difficult for me. But I think every time I used to come on stage to do Women Decoded, I did about 150 odd shows, but every time it used to give me that jitters. Like, I don't feel scared to come on stage when it's a proper play, but when you have to do a stand-up all by yourself, it is a little scary. So, but it was fun. It was fun all by myself, and that gave me it was a different experience. And I would love doing something like that once again. And thanks for loving Women Decoded. I think it was a different experience for me. Yes, pulling audiences is really, really difficult now. I remember during when I started my career in theater with Whose Wife Is It Anyway, we used to have regular shows on Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, Sundays. So Thursday was one show, Friday was one show, Saturday we used to have two shows, and Sundays we used to have two shows. So our week would be full with the shows. And as from 1996 to 2014, you know, about 10 years back, even the Thursdays and Fridays were cut off. Then we were only left with Saturday, Sundays. Then the afternoon shows were cut off because even those shows didn't fetch box offices. So we were left with Saturday, Sunday evening shows. And that is also diminishing right now. And mostly it's due to the prices going up, the ticket prices going up, the advertisement rates going up, the traffic conditions in the city where people are not so comfortable on traveling on their holidays to from one part of the city to another part of the city. So it is difficult. But I'm sure, you know, if we come up with good productions and good plays, people would want to travel from wherever they are to see whatever we are doing. So the idea is to come up with good, better productions and take help of people, social media, to spread the word around about the play. So it is difficult, but I think we will survive. We will make through it. So yeah, that's it. Women Decoded was something new for me also. So that's basically my journey, what all I have done. I'm lucky to have a couple of my films adapted. Also, I'm right now Three Cheers, which we have the play which that we've come up with. We are planning to soon, we are writing the script for the Punjabi version, the Gujarati version, and the Marathi version of a film. So I'm utilizing my lockdown time in writing those films. So that's happening with me currently. Also working on a new concept which I want to present it on stage, but I don't know with the whole lockdown scene how it's going to work out. But yes, hopefully things using this lockdown situation to create new stuff and to watch a lot of things which I didn't get a chance to do. Also read a lot of things. So I'm utilizing this time now. So yes, let's see what's in store. Thanks, Yogesh. And Yogesh is a great director himself, and he's done good Marathi plays, theater, Hindi plays. So it's Yogesh. Thanks, thank you, and more power to all the Mithibites. Yes, Poster Boys was a good film. It was the original Marathi film was produced by Shreyas, and then he offered us the film to adapt it in Hindi. So we did it in Hindi with Shreyas. But the original was a great film, and I love to adapt actually. There are a lot of films in my mind which I would love to adapt one day into Hindi, not only Hollywood, but films from other languages as well. So let's see how it goes. Yes, it is, I won't ignore that fact that it is detrimental to us. This definitely is, but I think the only way to do is to fight it and to create such productions which will draw the audiences back. I know there is a lot of fear right now because it is affecting not only the theater industry but the event industry as whole, and also the films. But I think it will, over a period of time, this fear will die down, and people would want to come back to theater. and watch us perform. And but yes, we need to give them the kind of productions that will attract them to come back and watch us. So hopefully, yes, hopefully by the beginning of next year, we'll have everything back to normal. Yes, apart from comedy, yes, I love thrillers. I love thrillers, and thrillers, I have written a couple of thrillers, but unfortunately people only expect comedies from me, and that's why I though I have written a couple of them, but I have never been able to really bring it on stage because people don't expect thrillers from me. And I feel sad sometimes that I wish I could, you know, get these thrillers on stage, but not. And yes, musical. I am very keen on doing something, a Broadway musical kind of a thing. Saif has already tried his hand on in that, and he's been pretty successful. So yes, something like that. I would love to do a musical, but before I do a musical, I would definitely love to do a thriller. And I love to watch thrillers. I have watched a lot of plays and taken some inspiration from them on how to engage the audience. I'm very comfortable with comedy as a genre, and but thriller, I need to watch a lot, read a lot, see a lot to understand how to engage your audiences where thrillers are concerned. Audience reaction which made you guys blank? Not exactly, but yes, there are moments when there have been we are disturbed when there are certain reactions from the audience, especially since the time mobile phones have come in. So we've grown from when there were no mobile phones to pagers to mobile phones. So yes, initially it was pagers when we used to be on stage, and suddenly the pagers used to start ticking and we used to get disturbed. And then the mobile phones, and but I think the audience now understands the importance of keeping their phones. There are one or two instances where people forget. I don't think anybody intentionally keeps their phones on or something like that. But there have been instances when we have requested audiences to please, we have stopped a performance and requested the audiences to please keep their phones on silent mode. There has been a very good incident which I would love to narrate right now is while we were doing our play Ye Dil Mange More, which was a musical sort of, and so there was this guy whose light was continuously flashing in the on the stage. So he had probably placed the mobile in such a position that every time it used to ring, the light used to flash on our faces, and that was distracting because every time we used to look in the audience, there was this one particular light that was flashing on our face. And we stopped the play and we requested the gentleman that, you know, it is disturbing us, so if you could just switch off your phone. And he got up and he requested us that, can I please keep my phone on, because my wife is in the hospital, and because she's attending to her father who's there in the hospital, and she was very keen to come and see this play. So right now she is watching this play, and I am sending her clips of this play because she was very keen to come on the play. So it was really touching that, you know, somebody was, he's such a huge fan that they want to see us, watch us. So we requested him to come on the front seat and allowed him to record the play and send clips. So it was a great incident, and it feels nice when people love you that way. Best plays which you like most, even not your plays? There are a lot of them. I have watched a lot of plays, Marathi theatre, Gujarati theatre, beautiful plays in Marathi, in Gujarati theatre, a lot of Broadway shows, West End shows. So I don't think I can specifically name something, but I recently, when I was in London, I happened to see a play called The Great Bank Robbery. I think it was one of the best plays I have seen. Very well executed, comedy, gimmicks, story, characterization, beautiful. So that's one of the latest plays that I remember, which was a great, a good show, and really enjoyed watching that. Like I said before, theater is going to survive, and it will survive. It has to survive because live entertainment is here to stay. So I think when live entertainment is here to stay, because when I remember when television started, people said ki abhi to Saturday Sunday film aayegi aur ye theater nahi chalne wala Saturday Sunday, but still थिएटर चला. फिर जब केबल टीवी आया तो लोगों ने कहने शुरू कर दिया कि अब लोग केबल टीवी से ऑक्यूपाइड है तो क्यों थिएटर देखने आएंगे, बट स्टिल थिएटर सर्वाइव. बिग ब्लॉकबस्टर फिल्म्स केम इन, स्टिल थिएटर सर्वाइव. द आईपीएल केम इन, वी फेस्ड अ लिटिल डिफिकल्टीज इन द फर्स्ट सेकेंड सीजन, बट आफ्टर दैट थिएटर स्टिल सर्वाइव. सो आई डोंट थिंक it is not that it's not going to survive, because I think we sort of, all the theater guys have this ability to fight back and come up with great productions which draw the audiences to them. So theater is going to survive, and I'm very positive and very hopeful that people will come back to theaters and flock theaters and watch plays. You thanks KU, that's really kind of you to appreciate, and thanks for supporting, because we really need KU. It's not just because that we are associated, but we really need people like you supporting theater and live entertainment, because it's a different kind of a high the audiences get, the performers get, and hopefully if we are able to give good products to the audiences, they will keep coming to theater. I don't think we should get remotely scared of people not coming to theater. I feel that they will keep coming back, and we will keep delivering good products, and we will keep making them smile and go back with loads of laughter. So yes, I think theater is going to survive. So I think I've said it all. Whatever was there, what I am today, I am thankful to theater. I'm thankful to my actors, co-actors who've supported me, my producers who have supported me in producing these lovely productions. My proud moment of my life, I don't know. I think every play, the first show, is a very proud moment for me if it is appreciated. Three Cheers, when we opened, everybody, including us, the producers, we were skeptical ki yaar ye run through to aise hua hai, grand rehearsal, pata nahi opening show kaise hoga. But when Keyur comes and hugs me and says, Paritosh, it was a great show, and Rashmin bhai came and hugged me and said it was a great show. So every time when you deliver something and when people appreciate it, and it's a proud moment. So it's not a single, there's no single moment which I can say is a proud moment for me. Every show, I think when people appreciate it, when they clap, when they laugh, when they're happy and they go back with fond memories, that's a proud moment for me. I think we've more or less said it all, and so thank you guys for being here. Hope I share some moments when you first met with Jayesh Thakkar, Balwinder Singh Suri. Oh, so Jayesh, he was the associate director with Dinyarji. He was Dinyar Contractors associate director, and so I met him when I started my theater career in 1996. Ballu, Balwinder Singh Suri, whom we fondly called Ballu, he we were college buddies and we started doing intercollegiate theater together. From then we did our first show Campus on ZTV together, and then when I started my theater production company, he joined me as an actor first, and then he came on board as a partner, and that's how we know each other. So it's been a 25-30 year journey for all of us. So yes, thank you guys, thank you for everything, and it's been great talking to you. Thanks for this lovely opportunity. It was a different, wonderful, nice experience, and yes, this is also a proud moment for me that I have been able to talk through for the last 30 minutes. So thank you, and take care, and be home and stay safe. Bye.